way there was a genocide carried on just a few days back when America was celebrating, you know, the inauguration of Jerusalem as Israel's capital. At the same time, Palestinian people were being killed, were being massacred. And they were celebrating. American embassy, Melania Trump, all of them, they were saying that this is a great day for world peace. This is a great day for democracy. So it is quite clear that for the Israel and for the United States, massacre of Palestinians is a great day for world peace.
Since March 30th, people in Gaza, most of whom are refugees since 1948, have been protesting for their right to return to their homes. These protests culminated when near Nakba Day, which is the day which is commemorated as the day when the catastrophe hit Palestinians and Israel was established by ethnically cleansing Palestinians. This is the 70th year of that Nakba, although that Nakba is ongoing and people are still being dispossessed as we are talking. And as a response to that, the responsibility on the global community is not only to sit and watch this massacre unfolding, but actually to take action. Primarily, the BDS movement has said that as a response to this massacre, the world should be demanding a military embargo on Israel. It is these arms that enable Israel to do what it's doing, and the arms trade, which is making this really a viable thing for Israel to every 2-3 years massacre Palestinians, and also do it constantly. So there are massacres, periods of massacres, and then there are these attacks regularly. All of this requires an end to these arms and these arms trade that make this viable. It's important to mention here that India, in fact, buys 50% of the arms that Israel exports.
So Palestine ki lahai zindabad!
Zindabad! Zindabad!
Kazalal me murdabad!
Murdabad! Murdabad!
We are a nation who have fought against imperialism. We have fought against the British colonizers, and we have had a history of standing with the Palestinian people. We demand from the Narendra Modi government that it must immediately, you know, break its silence. It must take a position against the genocide of Palestinians, and it must break all ties, especially, you know, the armed deals with Israel. And if the Narendra Modi government doesn't do that, it is betraying the mandate of the Indian people. That is why we all are here today.
Modi praises Hitler, and Modi also praises Zionism, because Hindutva is probably this aggressive Hindutva that he professes probably works as a chemistry, you know, a glue between all these regressive fascist ideologies.
Long live
Palestine! Long live!
Long live! Long live
Palestine! Long live!
Long live! Long live!
It is our duty to stand in solidarity with these people. I represent no student union, but as a human being, it is my duty to be here, to stand with these people and to talk about their rights.